Am I recording? I guess so, because it's the red thing is on, you know. But, you know, I'm down here in my basement and I'm doing some work. I'm going to show y'all some of the pieces that I've done. And hopefully, I don't know if I can, maybe I should bring them on this side instead of on that side. But this is like some of the pieces I'm working on. I done worked on already. That's two necklaces, actually, that I've done. I don't know if you can see them real good. Yeah, you can see them if I do it like that. But anyway, you know, I'm kind of like looking on Facebook. I am really kind of speechless about some of the things I'm reading, as well as, you know, some of the things I'm seeing, you know, videos and things like that. I'm just kind of, I'm at a loss for words right now. For what to say about all of these police killings and, you know, and then the fact that we also kill each other, too. So, you know, it's just kind of like, I don't know what the solutions to these problems are. I mean, it's just like, I just don't know what to say about it. You know, I don't know what the solution is. I know they're over there in Missouri tearing up shit. And then, you know, I think, you know, that is, I guess, a good way to get off your anger and frustrations about what's going on, you know. But at the end of the day, when everything dies down and, you know, after the person who killed the young man has been brought to justice, you know, how are they going to rebuild or build a community? Because obviously I don't think they even had one, but I guess I'm just wondering, how are they going to, you know, rebuild things? Will businesses come back? Because I just got a feeling that it's not going to be a good thing after all of this has died down, and it will die down. I mean, this is how it goes. It will die down. And, you know, at the end of the day, I just wonder if all of this, you know, fighting and looting and, you know, firebombing and, you know, all of this stuff, you know, what good will it do at the end of the day if what you want is the person who did the murder to be charged for that murder? But see, it's something a little bit deeper than just this, because you have policemen all over the country who are just buck wild. And, you know, and see, I've always been under the mind that simply because these people are uniformed officers and they take a test and, you know, they probably pass some kind of psych evaluation or whatever, initial psych evaluation, that these people got deep-seated shit going on inside of them. And I don't think there's a law or anything other than consequences for something they do. And that's after they've done something to somebody. I guess what I'm trying to say is, what is the preventative measure for all of this? Is it, you know, like, you know, we used to think that if, you know, we could police ourselves, things would be better. But I'm just thinking that it's a whole psychology when it comes to policing. You know what I'm saying? And it's kind of like, these people who put themselves in charge of others sometimes think that they're above other people. And because they've been given this authority, they go overboard with the authority. Whereas you're not allowed as a citizen to be angry for them to stop you for nothing, to say anything about your being stopped for nothing. They don't want you to ask any questions. Even if you say it in a nice way, they won't want you, when they say shut the fuck up, That's what they want you to do. And you a grown ass woman or man. And then they feel like they could just beat the dog shit out of you and kill you if they choose at that particular moment. You know, because I guess from hindsight or past experience, they see that policemen get off with killing citizens. So, you know, I'm just a little upset, first of all, because I think that the looting and the bombing and all of that stuff, the burnings that the people are doing are a reaction. But I also think that at the end of the day, it's not going to be good for them at the end of the day. Their whole community is going to be destroyed even after they arrest this police officer. He get justice, the mother filed a civil lawsuit, you know what I'm saying? And probably get some kind of settlement where she can move the fuck up out of there. You know what I'm saying? The people who's left go be left with that fucking blight that they created. You know? And all the businesses that they had patronized before will be gone. And, you know, I'm just kind of torn with the whole idea of this whole thing. It's just kind of mind-boggling for me. You know, I understand it, but then I also see futuristically that it's not going to be good. You know, I'm from the 60s, and I remember when, they had the rebellion in the 60s. And even some of the areas, they never were the same. I mean, and even though some of them have had businesses come back in, it's still foreign people. They're not owned by black people. It's still, you know, it's still the same scenario is what I'm saying. Because even then we were saying that these aren't our businesses and this is so and so and so. But who replaced them? Asians, Indians, you know, India Indians. Very few, you know, black businesses are in these various places, you know, corporations, like chains and things like that. But very few businesses replace those businesses that they torched and tore up and things. It was only just a different kind of people. First it was Jews, then now come the Asians and the doggone Indian people. So I'm wondering, you know, in this instance, have anyone learned from history, and will they rebuild Ferguson, Missouri with their own businesses? Will they rebuild it, you know, so it'll be a place that they can live in? Because I'm telling you, it's going to be years before. And I don't know how it was before then. I don't know if it was all that, but anyway, you got a quick trick, a quick pick, whatever the name of that grocery store, that business is, in those hair places. I mean, anytime you got those around in your community where you live at, like right up the street, you can kind of guess the caliber of the neighborhood or whatever. But I'm just thinking that now that they're gone, you know, in the grocery store, I'm just wondering, you know, how are they gonna do for when everything calms down? That's what I'm thinking about. You know, I understand that they feel as though they have to, have that outlet of violence and that outlet of destruction. I understand that because, you know, when you have a people that are literally captive and they break out of their cells, they just go buck wild. They have no organization. So they just, you know, feed into their anger and disgust and hatred and, you know, disappointments and things like that. They're blame and, you know, and they just go crazy. Nobody thinks about, you know, a month from now, it's getting ready to be wintertime, you know, in about 2 or 3 months when all this stuff starts to quelling down and it starts getting cold outside. I mean, nobody's thinking about that. They're just, you know, operating on anger energy right now. And I think that one of the pitfalls that we have as subjects is that we never think things out. You know, we never plan things out. And I heard, read somewhere that there were outside agitators that started this stuff. And they always say that some outside agitators come in and they start doing those types of things. But, you know, who knows? All I know is that 2 or 3 months down the road, you know, and I don't know if anybody's going to be there with a camera to show the aftermath, because that's what I think about the aftermath of this whole debacle, is how are the people going to fare then, you know, when they have absolutely, you know, not even the meager conveniences that they had prior to this. You know, so I just think about things like that, you know, and please don't bite my damn head off about the situation. I just think further than the day. That's all. You know, I think about, you know, what's going to happen 2 or 3 months from now, you know, when everything is quieted down. What are the people going to do? The ones who's doing all of these acts of, you know, anger and things and frustration and things like that. You know, what are they going to do? Because these were places that they frequented. This was the community that they lived in. So, you know, I'm just really wondering how they're going to fare, because, you know, when you can look back at something, because a lot of these people weren't born in the 60s. A lot of them don't even remember the Rodney King incidents, you know. And so when you look back, you'd be like, maybe rebellions have to be planned and organized, and that maybe, you know, you got to kind of keep the fringes back. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. But anyway, like I said, I just wanted to, you know, share my thoughts on that, because it's been kind of eating at me, and I've been reading Facebook, and I'm kind of disappointed with some of the comments that I see on Facebook, because none of these people actually live there. You know what I'm saying? They justifying these people doing these things. But when all this shit is over, are they going to send a care package to those people? Because they're definitely going to need one. You know what I'm saying? Because everything else is gone. And so I'm just wondering, you know, like I said, I'm just wondering when it's all over, when it's all said and done, when it's all ended, what's going to be the outcome? What are they going to do then? I want to show y'all something too while I'm working. See, these are some pieces that I'm working on right now. I don't know if you can see them. Let me see. I'm going to put my phone right there. See, these are some I'm working on right now. They'll be ready in a little while. I've been working on these for about a month, man. But they'll be ready in a little while. But anyway, you know, this is my work area, just to let y'all know. But anyway, so I'm down here in my basement, and I'm just thinking, I'm working, I'm thinking, you know, about things and what's going on. And, you know, it really saddens me. And then I keep getting these reports from other places about policemen snatching people up and still killing people. And I'm like, look, you know, this police killing folk, that's a mentality that's in the individual policeman. And who's to say when it gets turned on? Now, I'm going to tell y'all something. This is just something between you and I, okay, and my YouTube family here. I got a theory. You know, I've been looking at these documentaries about how they're utilizing sound waves, you know, like sonic waves or something like that. And I'm thinking, you know, I'm saying, what if they have some kind of frequency that some people are more susceptible to, and it causes them to kind of like wig out? Because when I look at all the incidents, like all the murders amongst Black people in Chicago at a specific period of time, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, it just makes me think that it's something more sinister going on. I know it sounds crazy, but, you know, it just seems like there's something going on where there's some way that they are tapping into something, and maybe they don't even know it. They fucking around up there in them laboratories and things, and maybe they don't even know that they're releasing something in the atmosphere that affects some people, and these people subsequently can't rationalize their behavior or rationalize or control their emotions and behavior and just, you know, go to killing one another. Because things are just too fucking spontaneous and it's too many sometimes at the same time is what I'm saying. So that's, you know, that's just my little theory between you and I could be wrong. You know what I'm saying? But it's got to be an explanation for this. You know, it's got to be a reason why things are happening in such a, I don't know, it seems like spontaneous way. You know what I'm saying? Where people are just wigging out, you know, and just killing each other. So I'm just wondering if it's something going on in laboratories or, you know, things of that nature. I don't know, y'all. But anyway, those are my thoughts as I work down here in my basement and I go read Facebook. And I've been so into Facebook. I'm really thinking about just cutting it off for a little while because it maybe come back 2 or 3 months later. But my jewelry page is attached to my Facebook page. So I don't know, maybe I'll just open up a whole different Facebook page or something and just kind of shut this one down for a little while. Because it is every time I read something, it just seems like people don't think rationally. They're wholeheartedly justifying the things that's going without thinking about the future, you know, the future of these people. So I'm hoping that all of those who, you know, are encouragement for this kind of behavior, that they're putting together care packages for these people in Ferguson, Missouri, because they're definitely going to need it. And I'd say about a month or two. And as I said before, winter is going to be upon them. And I really think that the depressing part is going to be after it's all quieted down and the people look at their community after it's all over. So anyway, this is Queenie Fama. I am the Truth Terrorist. And thank you so much for listening and have a great day, everybody.